السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The event of Ghadir. Sometimes we talk about it to those who believe in it, the followers of Ahlul Bayt. And sometimes we talk about it with those who are not yet clear about it, who are Muslims like us, but they were not being taught about Ghadir since childhood, and we don't blame them because their fathers and forefathers did not concentrate on Ghadir. And sometimes we talk about it with non-Muslims, and I feel strongly that these three angles must be dealt with. Number one, we should remind all those who believe in Ghadir that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alih said, أَلَا فَلْيُبْلِغْ الشاهد الغائب. Everyone who knows should convey the message to those who don't know. We know about Al-Ghadir. What about our responsibility towards those who don't know about it? Till today, millions of Muslims don't know about Al-Ghadir simply because they don't read their own books, because Al-Ghadir is mentioned in all the books belonging to all schools of thought, up to the extent that very eminent Sunni scholars have written books about Man Kuntu Mawlah. You will find Man Kuntu Mawlah Fa'aliyu Mawlah in the books of Al-Tabari, in books of Abdullah bin Ahmed bin Hanbal, in the books of many main eminent Sunni scholars. But unfortunately, many Muslims are not yet clear what happened in Al-Ghadir. Now, many of them, when they listen to Al-Ghadir, hear Al-Ghadir, they don't know what is Ghadir. I say, go to the books, search Man Kuntu Mawlah, see hundreds of hadiths confirming that the Prophet, peace be upon him and his whole progeny, said when he came back from his farewell Hajj in front of 125,000 companions who just completed their Hajj, in front of all of them he said, أَلَسْتُ أَوْلَى بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Am I not more entitled on the believers than themselves, on themselves? All said, yes. Oh, the messenger of Allah, he took the hand of Ali, raised it, and said, مَنْ كُنْتُ مَوْلَاهُ فَعَلِيٌّ مَوْلَاهُ. For whomsoever I am the master, Ali is the master. The Prophet wanted the Ummah to remain united. And one of the most important messages of Ghadir to all Muslims is the message of unity. We are here celebrating Al-Ghadir to remind ourselves that the Ummah is one Ummah under one leadership, the leadership which Allah wanted, the leadership of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And no Muslim denies the greatness of Ali ibn Abi Talib with degrees. But Ali ibn Abi Talib is a common factor which can easily create more harmony among Muslims. I would like to invite from this pulpit, from Ahl Bayt TV, those who listen, those who view, please go through any book that you can, search about Man Kuntu Mawlah, and see the hadiths about it, and take the lesson that you can take from the Prophet, because the Prophet clearly said, أَلَا فَلْيُبْلِغْ الشَّاهِدُ الْغَائِبُ. The followers of Ahlul Bayt are responsible to convey the message. General Muslims should take care to maintain the unity, though there are differences among some Muslim scholars, but that does not mean that we dispute among ourselves. Islam gives the freedom of research. We respect every Muslim, though we believe that the real Islam is the Islam of the Prophet and Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, with no doubt. But every Muslim who says the kalima, الشهادتين, we look at him as we look at ourselves, Muslim. All Muslims from all sects are Muslims. Also, we would like to talk to non-Muslims and tell them, did you read something about Imam Ali alayhi salam? Imam Ali, the leader about whom the United Nations in 2000, August, there was a summit in New York in the United Nations building, where that time the Secretary General of the United Nations was Kofi Annan. And in that summit, which was Millennium Religious and Spiritual Summit, the talk of Imam Ali came. And then in 2002, the United Nations issued a circular, which is now available in the internet, you can find it, asking the rulers, the governors, the heads of states in Muslim countries to take lessons from Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib. This is a great honor for us, the followers of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. And this is an invitation to all those who want the truth to read about Ali ibn Abi Talib. From London, from this TV station, let us invite those who want to know the real values of humanity, the real values of justice, the real values of equality among human beings. Read Ali ibn Abi Talib. Read Nahj al-Balagha. Read the man who says openly that every human being is either your brother in faith or your equal or partner in humanity. I think we cannot find any example after the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him and his holy progeny, like Ali ibn Abi Talib. Today, the problems in this world are increasing and the people are looking for solutions, and Ali ibn Abi Talib has the solution for every human being. In 1999, there was a conference in Cape Town, South Africa. In that conference, Nelson Mandela was participating, and he spoke great impressions that he had about Islam, the Prophet, and Ali ibn Abi Talib, specifically. I would like from here to invite everyone to have a look at Nahj al-Balagha, which is available, just click it on your computer. Nahj al-Balagha, N-A-H-J-U-L, then Balagha, B-A-L-A-G-H-A, and then you have a look and read and see the great oceans of light that Ali ibn Abi Talib can guide us and all the human beings. I would like also to appreciate the effort of giving the awards of Ahl al-Bayt. We, the followers of Ahl al-Bayt, are one family, in fact. And this family should be always cooperating with each other. And these awards should encourage our people to do more. In fact, the real followers of Ahlul Bayt are best in every field. Best in knowledge, best in service, best in behavior, best in character, best in every dimension. That is the real criteria of the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you, bless this TV station and all those who are working for the service of the community. We pray to Allah to keep this family of the followers of Ahlul Bayt. We are one family, worldwide family, without any difference like nationality, ethnic, no difference. All of us belong to one family, the followers of Ahlul Bayt, the followers of the truth. May Allah bless this family and bless all those who are working sincerely to serve the community and the humanity. May Allah bless you all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.